Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Wine Up TV. I'm your host, Wayne, with Camille. And when we come back, we're going to talk about a couple of wines from California. See you in a second. Thanks a lot for watching, by the way. I'd like to keep these shows nice, short, sweet, to the point, because there's so many wines out there. But today's show, we do a Pinot Noir from Monterey County, which is the Han. And I tried it. I liked it so much, it's going to be on the show. And then a Raymond R. Collection. This is a field blend. And when I lived down in Napa, I used to go over to Raymond quite a bit. And they just underwent a very major renovation. And they're back to where they should be. And that's making great wine and having a great facility for you guys to go visit. Camille, what's going on?
What's going on?
Yeah.
Filming some shows with the Wiz.
Ooh, how's that going for you?
I like it.
Checks in
I
the
like
mail.
It. It's all right.
You remember rehab.
It's the pan gig?
Rehab.
Nice.
It's for quitters. You don't look like a quitter.
No,
we ain't no quitter. Anyway, guys, first wine we're going to talk about is the Han family. And they've been making wine for a long time. Nikki Han, Pinot Noir, vintage 2010. This is Oregon. And it's kind of hard to sell a California Pinot Noir in Oregon, but I do. And the price on this wine is just spot on. It's $12.99 a bottle. You're going to notice with California Pinots are a little bit more darker and richer in color. It's a little warmer down on the coast down there. And I remember back in the day when Monterey was planting its grapes, they planted a lot of Cabernet and Merlot there, and they found out that it was too cold after a while to grow those grape varietals, and it never obtained the ripeness that they were hoping. It's sunny there a lot, it just never got warm enough. So they've gone back to cooler climate varietals, and I think they've nailed it with this Pinot. So what are you thinking?
Well, I'm very partial to Oregon Pinots.
I know you are.
Oregon is where I cut my teeth in the wine industry, so we'll see.
It is, all right. So let's give this a little smell. Well,
definitely a Pinot.
It's completely, yeah, but it's a bigger Pinot.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, Oregon Pinots are more aromatic, and they're a little more gentle.
Right. We get some big Pinots up here sometimes. But
yeah, the right vintages, absolutely. But still, Oregon Pinots tend to be a little bit more floral. This is a little, I'm not saying this is bad at all. This is just different, that's all. And that's the cool thing with wine, guys, liquid geography, it's all going to be different. So let's give this a...
It is noticeably different, though.
I got like really crushed raspberries in that, you know? A little almost allspice. I love the silky tannins on this wine. You guys, you can't go wrong with this wine for $12.99 a bottle.
Oh.
I like that. No, it does have a nice raspberry in the mouthfeel. It's very, very good. It's right on the money. I think this is a great value wine. And matter of fact, the Hans switched out all their labels. And I'll show you. They went from these labels here, which weren't as cool, to these labels here, which are very cool. So it's just good job for them.
Yeah.
You know, I think every label and every wine brand has to evolve. And what catches your eye? Wines sell because they got cool labels. And this is a lot cooler than this one. But they did a nice job with this wine.
You know, I think Pinot's a great Thanksgiving dinner wine too.
Oh, is that coming up?
Thanksgiving's coming up,
So is my birthday.
Yeah, right after.
Right after. Wow, fitty. Fitty.
Wow. I'm dating an old man.
Wow. You just told him we're dating.
Oops.
Yeah, oopsies. Wow. That's okay. Yum.
Yeah, very nice.
Very nice wine. All right. Next one. Field blend number 7. Cab Sauv, Zinfandel, Cab Franc, Petit Verdot, Petit Syrah, Malbec, and what's the last one? Yeah, I did. No. It's a field blend. One nice thing about wines coming from out of California, actually this these grapes, this says Field of California, so the grapes in this bottle come from anywhere in California. But a lot of this fruit does get sourced out of Napa and Sonoma counties. So
I've always been a big fan of Raymond Wines, but I know them for Merlot. They're really famous for the Merlot.
Yeah. And you know, for a while there, I remember when I worked at Mondavi back in the mid-90s, I used to go to Raymond. I don't want to say it was dumpy, because it's a nice facility, but I just read that they underwent a multi-million dollar renovation, and I heard
have
it's
to
just...
check it out.
Yeah. Matter of fact, guys, give me a call. Come down and talk to the winemaker. I am planning a trip to Napa. We're going to go down to Southern Oregon, too, aren't we?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We're going everywhere.
Yeah, you know, finally, summer's over, which I kind of miss summer, but I was so busy giving tours, and I'm just swamped still. You know, Thanksgiving's coming up, and that's a great tour weekend. A lot of the wineries that aren't open to the public are open to the public. Check that out. Did you like
what
that?
What is this?
Look
your
at
wine
this.
Club? Wow.
She has been kicking butt and really jamming on this stuff. And Dan, thank you for all your help as well. International Wine Discovery. So, guys, what we're going to do with this is every month we're going to focus on a different country and a different region within that country. And we're going to have three different levels. You know, it's your typical wine club, but not typical, because I'm going to send you on cardstock all these really cool maps. This is the starter kits, like $19.99. But it's going to have more stuff in it than this. This is just going to be, got to get some stuff. This is really going to be cool. So it has glossary of wine terms, wine tasting terminology, little intro. And then we have maps of Argentina and Australia. We'll go on and on and on. So this is going to be a great gift for somebody for the holidays.
And most wine clubs, you join at a winery, and you're limited to the wines that the winery has to provide for you. This, we're going to provide wines from all over the world.
Yeah, we are. We're going to rock it.
Yeah, we are.
This is going to be a great little thing to be a member of. Then we're going to have probably every 6 months, a nice event for the wine club members, just like they do with the wineries. We're going to have it down here, and as it gets bigger and bigger, I'll start renting out some really nice spaces to host these things at. But let's give this thing a smell. It needed to sit down and open
it
up.
It did. That's a confusing nose on there.
Yeah, when I first opened it, I'm going, well, let's talk for a second.
It takes a lot to confuse this nose over
here. I'm telling you. Call me Toucan Harry. Maybe not. Okay. Maybe not. All right. So, field blend. I'm not, maritage is a word that describes a lot of Napa Valley blends. This is just a field blend, and it's definitely blown off. But I've got that nice, it's a little dusty.
Yeah.
The blackberry, black cherry, little cigar box to it. Yeah, it's just nice. A little black olive, I get. Mm-hmm. All right, let's give this thing a taste.
I think it comes together in the mouth. Though.
It does. $12.99. It's not going to break the bank. Raymond does make several different wines, and they have their higher end program. This is like their intro level, and this is really nice.
It is.
I like it. It's got a really nice long finish.
Right. There's a lot more fruit in the finish than there was in the nose. It was a nice, surprising little wine.
Absolutely. No, this is
For the price.
Yeah, I like that. Hi, guys. Thanks for joining. And remember, every Friday night, right here from 5 to 8, I have a guest speaker, winemaker, distributor. We're going to throw it down like only I can throw it down here in Portland, Oregon. Thanks a lot, guys. See you later.